Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I want to showcase what I think is the best or top pick relaxed hair products for a healthy deluxe wash day or weekly wash day routine that will make your hair feel amazing. I have tried numerous products, as you know, on this channel, and these products are not new, but I feel like I want to handpick each product to say, okay, use this shampoo, use this conditioner, use this deep moisturizer, use this leave-in, this is the best oil. This everything essential in one video for the perfect deluxe relaxed hair feeling weekly wash day routine. So let's jump right into the video, shall we? So the first product on my list, of course, I have talked about this product so many times, you're probably annoyed right now with me, but I just have to give it up for this shampoo. I have tried other shampoos that which I have found, especially a deluxe or luxurious type of shampoo, but if you don't have the $28 coins to spend on a tiny bottle, which is I'm referencing Olaplex, of course, you can always use a motion shampoo. And what I do love about this shampoo is that it gives me an experience. I feel so luxurious using this. It just calms me. It just feels so moisturizing and slippery and just nice on my hands, and I just love the feeling that it gives. It gives you great result, but trust me, the experience of going through the motion of shampooing your hair is also phenomenal. So I have to give it up to this shampoo. It's one of the best and I will hold on to it forever. This is definitely my top pick for a healthy or a deluxe luscious type of relaxed hair wash day. Must have. I was so eager, child, to get into the shampoo that I forgot the first stage that I do, or the first step. And this one is using the Olaplex Hair Perfector number 3. It repairs and strengthens all hair types. And I have done a dedicated video where I test and tried out Olaplex. And I must say, I practically crapped on this thing just a tiny little bit. I mean, I was a little bit rough, but I've been using this and I feel like this incorporated with the other products, I am seeing tremendous results. I feel like my hair is so strong that I have to give it up to this, and I feel like it's just essential to use before you go in with your conditioner. You don't have to use a shampoo if you don't want to. I love the shampoo, which is like a bougie first when it comes to shampoo, otherwise on my motions. This one is essential, and it's definitely for if you feel like you have really damaged hair. And I feel like if you don't have damaged hair to that, you can always use this as a maintenance. And this is used for on your damp hair, like you rinse out your hair before you go in with your shampoo, you just go ahead and put this in for about 10 minutes or more, leave it on, and then rinse it out and apply your shampoo. And this helps to strengthen the bonds in your hair and to make sure to repair the damage here. So I can't go without this. I feel like it's a necessity within your wash day. And I mean, relaxed hair is something that it needs a lot of tender love and care, and you want to, even if you don't really damage your hair, just to prevent things. Prevention is better than cure, right? So let's just get into this one. I would say this is a definite must-have. So let's revert back to the shampoo. Let's pretend that that didn't happen and we were just coming from the shampoo. I would say, and everyone knows I've talked about this, I ain't giving up this bad boy here, my deep conditioner, which is the Crescipelio deep conditioner. And this, it's just, I wish you could just feel how luxurious it feels. It feels so slippery, so moisturizing your hair. Even rinsing it out is just an experience. Your hair fills with so much moisture. Your hair will just soak up all the suppleness of this deep conditioner, and I'm not letting this bad boy go. Absolutely not. I leave this in for about 15 to 20 minutes and rinse it out. It works best to me when you use heat. You don't have to use heat if you don't want to use heat, but you can always get like a hooded dryer or use your blow dryer just to do some circular motion just to trap some heat into your hair. You can sit down for another 5 minutes and then rinse it out. It's one of the best deep conditioner I've ever used. I talked about this. I feel like I sound like a broken record, but when you love something and something really works, you just have to give it its due diligence, right? If to Caesar, what is due to Caesar? And this Caesar right here is Caesaring, okay? So the next one on my list, of course, after you go in with your deep conditioner, it's the Keracure Humectant Cream Conditioner. And what I can say about this is most definitely it's very hydrating, does help to really detangle your hair. It has a great slip. The only dilemma that I have with this is that the bottle is just too small. Comparing to the shampoo, I wish it was a bit bigger, but no. I most definitely know why it's so small, because it's so good. So this is definitely one of my favorite detangling shampoo. I used to use Emotion, I still do, but I find this one to be a little bit more effective. So I'm just gonna stick with this one, and I like how easy it is to detangle my hair. So thumbs up to this conditioner, because she's slapping, honey. She's it. Okay, so after I rinse out my hair and everything, I have to go in with my setting lotion or wrapping lotion. I have been using Lauder Body. I have been using Kera Care, which is bomb too. I have been hunting down this setting lotion or wrapping lotion for a long time. And this was introduced to me by my friend as a hairstylist, and she has been using this for years. And she keeps raving about how effective and awesome this is. So I finally found it. Hopefully it's not a fake, but it doesn't feel like a fake. It does basically what she said it would. It makes it so easy to blow dry your hair. Throughout my other wash day routines, I don't think I've ever experienced blow dry my hair so quick. And sometimes I do towel dry a little bit, but I kid you not. Like, I know my Dyson blow dryer is very, the blow dry itself, not the other system. It's pretty intense and it blow dries your hair pretty fast. But this, it cuts that time in half. And I know for sure that this contributes to that, because it says here that it's very fast drying, it conditions, it has body, it gives a smoother wrap to your hair. It makes my hair so easy to detangle. It's a shame. It's just amazing. I have evolved from Lauder Body and I have stepped into Kera Care and now this Fantasia setting lotion, and I can tell you this is phenomenal. So this for me would be the ideal setting lotion that you need for your relaxed hair wash day routine. And the next one that I like most definitely, I love my Design Essential wrapping lotion, but this one takes the cake for me. I don't know, it makes my hair feel incredibly luxurious. It definitely leaves your hair soft. It leaves your hair silky. I feel like it gives me that silkiness that I'm looking for, because I love a silky blowout. Makes my week easier. It's more manageable, and I like that. I don't want to be in a fist fight with my hair. I just need it to stay and just be smooth and just easy to maneuver and comb out. So you definitely need a foaming lotion whenever you are blowing out your relaxed hair, and this is one of the best, and I will continue to buy this one because it's just bomb and you get a lot for your money, which is phenomenal. So hats off to Kera Care, because this is just great. Of course, you know I love my glossing polish, and I just don't like it to use after I'm blow drying my hair. I like to use it during my blow drying process where my hair is still wet, and you put this in, it helps to give your hair that shine, helps to detangle. And what I love to use too also is my Organ Oil of Morocco. That's what my friend introduced me to also. It's like she just loves to use that during blow drying. So I made sure to use these two, of course, because it's just phenomenal and it helps to give your hair incredible shine. I try not to use this after I am finished blow drying my hair, because if you put too much, it will weigh down your hair and let it not have like movement. You can get a little bit overstimulated with it. So I only put it on when my hair is wet and after I am done blow drying my hair, to go in with my detangling brush, because I like to get that silky feeling. I go in with my Proclaim just one more time, just to make sure that I am detangling my hair properly and I'm not breaking my hair apart. It helps the comb to glide through your hair better whenever you do that. So that's another step that I like to take, as you probably know already. But what? I can't even believe that I have to eat my words. Like, I crapped all over this so bad because I was just mad at the $28, which I'm still damn mad. But what I've found is that I don't use this anymore to put in my hair when it's wet. I use it at the end. I feel like it's just perfect. This is a little bit heavier than this one. This one is ideal for me, in my opinion, when you're just finished blow drying your hair and you want to help to tame your flyaways, or you want to give your hair just a little bit more shine and a little bit more upbeat and luxurious look to it. This helps. This takes the cake, and I can't believe that I was crapping all over it. I think I was just mad because in my mind I was saying this is Organ Oil of Morocco, but it's like a expensive bougie organ oil of Morocco. It's phenomenal. A little bit goes a long way, and I like to use it at the very last stage after I am finished blow drying my hair. I just like to go through my hair with it. So I do apologize that I kind of up to you. Just a little bit expensive, and you know what? It's okay. I'll continue to buy you for $28 because I'm loving the result that you're giving right now. Okay, so I do apologize. So I just wanted to get rid of like oils and glossing polish out of the way. What I like for leave-in, as I said earlier, I love that Care leave-in conditioner. It's just the smell that is getting to me, and I just have to step away from that before it takes me out. So what I'm liking is the Olaplex number 6 Bond Smoothener. Of all of the leave-ins that I'm trying, my favorite back then was, as you know, or probably you know if you're new to my channel, is Aussie leave-in. It was bomb. But after I had that whole ordeal with testing out the product line from Aussie, my mind just completely shifted from Aussie. I haven't touched that leave-in conditioner in a long time. Like, I haven't looked at it ever since I did that video. I probably used it one time after and I'm like, I'm done. Probably I got a fake. People commented on my video saying probably it's a fake, and I think it's a fake too. I'm just traumatized and I just don't want to look back. And I'm loving the Olaplex number 6 Bond Smoothener. What I find to be most effective is for you to use this after you detangle your hair. It doesn't work good to put it in when your hair is wet and you're about to go in and detangle. It makes the detangling process harder and it just makes it miserable, and I don't want to go through that again. So I decide to be fair with it and just work with it and try to incorporate different steps when it comes to this. And what I found is that just best to use it after I detangle my hair, just before I go into blow dry, and I have been loving the result. My hair loves it. It helps to reduce frizz, it moisturizes, and it protects your hair. And I could say bottle is small, but it's very mighty, and a little bit goes a long way. You know, I'll be skeptical when it comes to this versus this. It's like, come on, like, really? But a little bit really goes a long way. I just use a tiny amount because I like to divide my hair into half and just going from the roots down to the ends. And I, trust me, you don't need to put a whole lot. It's just remarkable. So I am through with the blow drying process and everything, laying your hair down, flyaways, all that good stuff. Next up, I want to talk about my scalp. And for my scalp, you have to show your tender love and care. But what I like to do is I like for my scalp to breathe a little bit after I wash my hair. I don't do anything to it for the first like 2 or 3 days. After, or on the third night rather, I like to go in with my curls, blueberry and mint scalp treatment. I used to do a combination of some oils, but sometimes it may get a little bit messy and I just don't want to deal with that. So what I do is I used to use the Crescipelio brand. I used to use their scalp treatment, but I have not been using that for a while. I need to re-up because it's good too. But this one I have been using, which is the curls, blueberry and mint scalp treatment, is just luxurious. It gives your scalp that tingling, that sensation that you need to promote healthy hair growth. And what it has in here is formulated with certified organic corn, mint, blueberry seeds and coconut oil to improve the health of your scalp and encourage healthy hair growth and smooth dries, irritate and itchy scalp issue. When I do use this, because sometimes my scalp can get itchy, I don't have that dilemma. And two, because I do wash my hair every week, I love to go in with this and it just gives me that calm, sensual feeling that is just soothing, and the mint that's does something for my scalp. And what I like to do too, I like to use my carrot seed oil. My friend raved about carrot seed oil for a long time, and especially if you have itchy scalp, carrot oil is phenomenal. I probably need to do another video where I do like a scalp treatment before I wash it if you have like itchy, dandruff, scalp, dry scalp issues, because I used to really suffer from that. And carrot seed oil, trust me, this is like gold in a bottle. So I like to use both of these. If you want your hair to just breathe a little bit, to have movement, just do it on the third night, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, and then go in again and just do your wash day again and leave your hair for about 3 more days and then continue the process. Just let your scalp breathe a little bit, but then just don't leave it neglected. Just remember her and that she's still present, okay? Yeah, so just remember your scalp, take good care of her, be kind to her, she will show you back love, and everything will be great, okay? We'll live happily ever after. So love, this is the end of enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you like my little concoction that I have been loving so far. Let me know your thoughts down below. Leave a comment, a like, and subscribe to my channel. Don't be stingy. Why not? It's free 99, okay? No cost. Support your girl. Thank you so much again. I see you in my next one, love. Bye.